Okay, so today I am going to be painting this old reel. It is a Texas Classic 5000. It's like a knockoff ambassador reel. I'm gonna be painting with these lacquer spray cans I got at Hobby Lobby. I'll do green, but first I gotta take it apart. So first, undo the handle. Gotta get that cover off the handle. Like that. And then you've got, on this one, it's got these little, like, locking things. So, I gotta try to get those off. I got this pick, so I'm just gonna stick it right in there. Well, I thought I was. Actually, you know what? First, I'm gonna take this nut off of here. Set that aside. Then I'm gonna take this little pick and I am going to pop it off just like that. Got it on the end. Set it aside next to that. And then I'm gonna pull off the little washer. Then the reel slide right off. Make sure you keep everything together. Then there's this little, I don't know, it's like a metal spring. I don't know what you'd call that. Put that next to it too. Then you're gonna unscrew the star drag handle. Okay. And then you're just gonna unscrew the tension knob and make sure you keep everything together so you can put it back correctly at the end. Next, I'm gonna unscrew these little rods that are holding it together. This part, we'll come to that next. Now on here, got these two screws. I'm just gonna unscrew them and hold tension because there's springs in here, and if you don't hold tension, the whole thing will fly apart and you'll never get it back together correctly. So unscrew those. Set that aside, and I don't mess with that on this one because there's nothing to paint there. Now on here, there's that bearing that I'm going to need to tape up, but other than that, this is good to go. So on to this one. I'm going to go ahead and take the spool out and set it to the side. Then you're just going to flip it over and unscrew this palm side, and kind of screwed. Just gonna, well, thought I had it unscrewed. Okay, now that I got that unscrewed, I'm just gonna pull it off, keep everything intact, and that's the other part I'm gonna be painting. I'm gonna keep these screws together. I'm just gonna go ahead and put them back in here. Now the funny thing about this is, on this reel, it's got this switch. Well, it does absolutely nothing. It's just there for looks, because if you look where it would connect here, it doesn't do anything. I mean, it would just flip back and forth. So I'm going to go ahead and take it off, because I don't want to paint it. And these are the pieces that we're going to be painting. Go get some tape, and I'll have those taped up. Alright, so I've got my painter's tape. So, I'm just gonna peel some off and start taping up the stuff that I don't want painted. So I've got this spray lacquer. I'm just gonna shake it up. Now I've got my parts I'm gonna paint kind of propped up on rocks so I can get complete coverage on everything. So I'm gonna shake that up real good. I don't want it to be okay. Now then, let's see, does it work? Okay, it works. Now, it says stay 10 to 12 inches away, so I'm going to try that. And just... okay, now this part. Okay. Okay, I'm going to let that dry and come back in about 5 or 10 minutes and do that again. And I'm probably going to put 3 or 4 coats on there. Alright, it's been about 15-ish minutes, so I'm going to come give it another coat. And just try to get everything that I missed before. Okay, so while I'm waiting on that to dry, I'm just gonna kind of clean up the reel a little bit because it's kind of nasty because it's old and never been cleaned, I don't think. Pretty sure it was used in salt water. So I'm gonna take this gears out of it. And just set that to the side. And I've just got this little pick. And I'm kind of picking, using the pick to scratch away all the old gummed up mess that's around every little nook and cranny.
Alright, so I put a couple more coats on each of these pieces, and now I'm just going to spray them with a clear coat just to kind of help protect it and seal it. Okay, and once that dries, I'm going to flip them over, kind of, make sure I get everything covered, and then we'll put it back together.
Okay, so we have got the painting finished, so now comes the fun part, getting it put back together. Just gonna get everything taken, all the tape off. Also already done. And now this, let's see here. There's that done. That looks good. Okay. So now I'm actually gonna go ahead and as I'm putting it together, kind of grease everything, oil everything. So I'm going to go ahead and start with this gear. I'm just going to take my finger and run it along it. Okay, actually, Q-tips are much better. This is the correct way to do everything. This is the way I know to do it. So we're gonna squeeze some on there and run it on there with my finger since it's a little gear. Okay, now I'm going to start assembling. So I'm going to put that piece on there. Okay, now I'm going to get this side plate and I'm going to put it. Well, I got to get the switch that does absolutely nothing. Probably just glue that in place, but I'm not going to. Now put that in just like that. Now, I'm gonna screw it in. Now, that side's done. I'm gonna take another Q-tip and get some grease on it. And I'm gonna, well, gotta leave all those in there. Just gonna run that grease all along there. I'm gonna put some more on there. Bit more. Okay. Now then, I'm going to take that, I'm going to put this piece right on there. Thank you. tension knob and that little piece that's in there. And I'm going to put a drop of oil on it. Because that's where the end of the spool hits. So I like to keep that well oiled. Just one drop of oil right in the middle of it. And I'm going to screw that back in. Well, I thought I was going to screw that back in. Get my pick and make sure it's positioned correctly. Okay. Now I'm going to take it. Take my star drag knob, screw it on. Okay. Now I've got my this thing. Alrighty. Spring thing. Got that. Put that on there. I'm gonna slide my handle on there that needs to be. I need to fix that, but another day. Now I'm gonna slide the little washer piece. Don't know if you can see that. And then I got a snap. Oh, I put that on there backwards. My bad. Make sure you put everything on exactly as it came off. If you don't, it's not going to work right. I'll just pop that back in on there. There we go. Got it on there. Good. I'm going to take my screw and make sure I got it on the right side. Screw it back on there. Get it tight with a pair of pliers. Take my, well, gotta get a little tighter so that that cap lines up good. Okay, now I got my cap lined up, and just take your, what did I do with my screwdriver? Did my screwdriver fall? Oh, there it is. Take it, just screw that in. Side's done. I'm going to tighten that star drag down. Good. It doesn't sound great because it's an old cheap reel. Now then, I'm going to go ahead and take a Q-tip. Well, I've already cleaned that. Never mind. I'm going to add a drop of oil right there on that end. Just like that. And I'm going to add a little bit of grease. All just like that. Just kind of get it on there good. And then I'm just going to use my finger to kind of get it in all those grooves. Okay. I'm going to take the oil. Put one drop on the end. Put one drop there. Just like that. And now then, I'm going to take it. Drop this end in here. Maybe. Okay. Now I'm going to take this. Slide it on there. actually going to use a little flathead screwdriver for this. Stick it right in there. I'll get back with you once I get it screwed in. Okay, I got it figured out. I didn't have everything lined up right. So, now I'm just going to tighten all these screws down. I'm going to get them on there by hand. And just tighten it down good.
Okay, sorry I gotta end it like this, but GoPro battery died and I don't have any more charge. But I forgot, under all this, I'll start working on it while I tell you. There's a ball bearing, and I forgot to oil it. You're supposed to oil it so it runs so it's smoother. So I can just get that off. Now you can see there's a bearing. Maybe. Well, can't really see it. Anyways, there's a bearing there, and you put a couple drops of oil in there, and that'll help make it smoother. And then you just gotta put everything back on there. Okay. Now the last thing to do before this reel is complete is to oil or grease this gear, the worm gear. Well, wow, that's good. My thing just blew up. Yeah, I guess I'm gonna have enough grease. Wow. Now I'm just gonna wind it to get it in there good. I'm gonna add a little bit more on once I get it. All right, now I'm just gonna screw that down, wind that till it gets good and lubricated in there. Now I'm going to take that other side and just remove the excess, and then you're going to want to also oil right here where that line guide goes in. Just put one drop of oil in there, and also put one drop of oil on the actual shaft that the worm gear's encased in. There we go. Now I'll just work that in there good. Pretty smooth. I mean, it's a cheap reel from the 90s, but I'm satisfied. That's it. Thanks for watching, and thanks for watching, and go ahead and subscribe if you would. I don't care if you like, it doesn't really do anything for me, but yeah.